Good afternoon, YouTube. And Jay is in my car right now, and he's pulling down the headliner because it fell on its own because it's a Ferrari, and that's what Ferraris do. They fall apart. So let me show you what's going on, and we're going to get a new headliner set up, hopefully. Okay. All right, so you can see this is the actual leather that goes up on the headliner, and it fell off completely.
Because of wonderful European glue.
Yeah.
That is the main
Texas
reason.
Texas heat with crappy glue, and that is like the foam sound deadener stuff, and it's on its way out. And by the way, that stuff's like old, and so it degrades and just kind of crumbles. So Jay's covered in all sorts of little debris.
It's okay.
Fun. So I think the plan is to... we're going to have to possibly pull off some of these trim pieces, maybe.
Yep.
And then re-glue it all together and get it back up there and tucked in under these trim pieces.
Definitely not for the faint of heart.
No. So as you can see, I hired someone because I'm not touching this shit. I'll fuck it up. It will look all like crap if I do it. So this is one of those where I don't think I have the DIY skills. So pay someone to have it done right. Look at that nasty stuff.
So what this piece is, this is the actual sound deadener. Well, they use a piece of, you know, whatever, the tar paper or whatever they use for a sound deadener. And once it's been heated up over a period of time, it just starts dropping on you. Yeah, you can push it back up and it'll stick for some time, but after maybe about, I don't know, half an hour, especially if you're in the sun, it'll be out to here.
Yeah.
So I put it up for right now, but what I'm going to do is start taking it apart so we can take the tar paper out because we have to re-glue it onto the actual body of the vehicle.
So it's literally just that seatbelt bolt hold on this whole piece?
Yeah, it's held in the bottom, I think. There might be a screw in the bottom.
Yeah, a screw or clip or something.
Yeah.
Wow.
But I may be able to pull the whole thing off. I've never taken one of these off. Wow. Yes, your viewers would like to know that. But usually with these, you start from the back and you work your way front.
Yeah, and then there's a screw up here.
Yeah, right here.
And then hopefully a whole trim piece along the top. Come on. So in case you needed some interior work done or upholstery work, Jay's your man. His website, actually, he's got a Facebook page and it's called Just Like New Interior, and he basically services the Austin area. So all of you people in Austin that have falling headliners or need to, like, for example, I'm probably gonna have him eventually do the bolsters on my seat because those are pretty worn. And don't tell the OCD people, but I may actually eventually fix the airbag cover because he can do that too. But I kind of want to drag that out longer so that you people can suffer that are, like, focusing on that. So, anyway. They bitched about it, so I'm like, I'm not going to fix it because you people complain about it.
Oh, they want to get it done now?
Yeah, they're like, go get that fixed.
Some people are really
driving me nuts. So I'm like, yeah.
OCD about it. So we have one screw right here on this corner.
Yeah.
Plus your sun visors.
Yeah.
Center, their overhead console. And then you have one more screw here. This whole piece should come off, and then there'll probably be a screw underneath here holding this trim in place. But if you notice over here, the way they built it is the way they made the tar paper is it goes on the just barely on the inside over here, and then you have basically a lip over here. But this is what, see, it's already down.
Yeah,
again.
That was the one.
And I just
up.
And I just put it up there not even 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, that's totally.
So hard. That's why it's time to come down. So I'm gonna finish taking off this piece, remove this piece, and then I'll take the fire paper because you really don't have to take the front off. Although Dan wants me to do it so he can put his new camera mount in there.
You don't have to.
But I mean, it's actually if it's a matter of just loosening it, you can just loosen up these corners and drop it down. You should be able to reach in the
might
cord,
be able to, yeah.
You know, without having to take everything off again.
So that's the tar paper, and there's the actual roof.
Uh huh.
Wow. All right. That's what it...
Oh, nice. Slowly,
yeah.
Take it apart. You want to reuse it. Slowly. And not, you want to put your own piece of solid insulation, you sure can.
Ugh, that is some gross stuff.
Yeah. Better take care of it now than later.
Yeah.
Yay!
It's off.
Woo!
Hey! There it is.
Oh! Yes, want it done right. Take this piece off.
Wow.
You'll thank me later. Here. I'm gonna clean it. Well,
you know, It's totally degraded.
Yep. You must clean this stuff off. Glue that I use does not like this stuff. This is what every upholsterer use. Huh. We use this for a reason. We don't use 3M when it comes to headliners, when it comes to certain other things. We don't use Super 99 or 77, whatever these people are, whatever these other brands use. Now, go with the DAP Wellwood. You'll thank me later. You do it once, you do it right. I don't like doing the job twice. Another trick is when you're gluing, the longer you leave it set, the stronger the bond. Huh. It's with most anything, but in this stuff, because of how warm it is over here, like if you're in a 60 degree day, you know, I would say leave it for like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Any degree and above, you can two to five and you're good. Yep.
All right. So I ran a new wire for the new dash cam I got. I didn't finish it, all the wiring is just kind of laying down here for now, but and the old wiring's still there. I have to pull that all out, but I'm going to do that once. You know, another day when he's not here taking care of all this stuff. I didn't want to get in his way. Almost done. Get there. So I actually have to run. So he's going to finish up. I won't be able to film any more of the progress as it goes, but I'll show you the end product. So ready? I'm back. So had a little dinner businessy kind of thing. Anyway, sorry, I kind of missed out on Jay finishing up all the Ferrari stuff. So let me show you what it looks like. It is back to as good as new. So check that out. It looks beautiful. Everything is nice and tucked in and it's all sturdy and not falling down. Actually, you can feel the new insulation feels much better. So I want to give another quick shout out to Jay. He did an amazing job. His Facebook page is Just Like New Interior. If you're in the Austin area, you can use his services. Pretty affordable. So that job was $500. So certainly a lot cheaper than taking it to any sort of dealership. And he did a hell of a good job. So I am very pleased. Couldn't ask for better. Good price. All the good stuff. So there you have it. Repairing the headliner. So the question is, could I have done that myself and DIY done that? It's questionable. Probably, but not having seen, you know, like I would have had to research how to do that and all that sort of stuff. I probably would have screwed it up. And I personally, you know, when it comes to stuff that look like you, when you have to make it look really good, I'm not very good at that. Like I can turn bolts and replace parts and things like that, but like paint, you know, detailing, interior, I'm not that great at. So those are kind of the things where I know my limitations and I kind of would rather pay someone else because they just have a better skill than me. And I know I don't have that skill. So, geez, I've been looking at the wrong thing the whole time. Sorry, fall into the old habits. But anyway, so Jay did an awesome job and you guys are also awesome. So you should probably subscribe. Watch that video. Give me the thumbs up. Give Jay the thumbs up. And we'll be doing more car stuff very soon. So we'll see you then.